Good morning, Delaware. You are now tuned in to this week's previously recorded worship services from the East Zion Fair Baptist Church in Wilmington, Delaware. Wilmington's most exciting church.
Wonderful if you just woke up that way, but we have the ability to set our mind in Jesus. So won't you sing this song with us? I woke up this morning with my mind stayed on the Lord. Yes. I woke up this morning with my mind
stayed.
Jesus said,
"Repent of your sins and be baptized." brothers and sisters. I want to welcome you back to life. Back to the one that can make your next chapter your best chapter. Hallelujah.
How can it be that you love the most unlovable part of me? Of me. How could you see your life was the only gift I'll ever need to be free? It's amazing with you. I win even if I lose. Everything's working for my good for
I greet you in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ and say welcome to the Ye Zion Fair Baptist Church, Wilmington's most exciting church, the church that love ya and anything you can do about it. It is a joy, it is a privilege to have each one of you who are worshiping with us today. I know for real, that you could have gone to any church in this city, but you took the time to worship with us today. And we consider it a personal privilege and an honor to have you with us. I pray that something is said or done that will literally transform your life. We want you to walk out of here knowing this, that we love you and anything you can do about it. Come back and visit us again. But until that time, know for today that you are welcome, welcome, and welcome.
Welcome. Welcome.
Announcements. Our Warriors in the Word Zoom Bible Study is every Thursday at 7 p.m. The Bible study starts with praise and worship, which will prepare you for the study of God's Word. Our National Prayer and Meditation Call occurs every Sunday and Wednesday morning at 5 a.m. This is our time as a people of God to hear an encouraging word and pray for miracles in every aspect of our lives. Join our National Prayer and Meditation Call directly dialing 319-527-2650. Sunday school is held every Sunday at 10:30 a.m. in the Fellowship Hall. Join us as we explore the fundamentals of our faith. Prayer is key to our access to the Lord. Join us every Wednesday for our noonday prayer at 12 noon in the sanctuary. We're back for our in-person live worship celebrations in the sanctuary every Sunday at 9 a.m. and 11:30 a.m. There's power being in the presence of the Lord. Join us weekly as we worship together at 9 and 11:30 a.m. every Sunday morning. Join us at 9 a.m. on YouTube and Facebook Live by typing Ye Zion Fair Baptist Church. There are four ways to give at EFBC. 1. Through Cash App using $EFBC1919. 2. Through Zelle, trustees at EzionFairChurch.org. 3. By mail, 1400 Beach Street, Wilmington, Delaware, 19801. And 4. Through the website, by MyEzionFair.org, and click the giving button. If you are in need of transportation to the church, please call the church by Friday at 5 p.m. You must be able to provide proof that you are fully vaccinated and do not have a vehicle of your own. To schedule a pickup, call the church at 302-652-9114, extension 110.
Joy when I think about what He done for me. Oh, I get joy when I think about
is mine. He's mine. He's mine in the morning. He's mine in the evening. He's all mine. Jesus is mine.
Yeah. on, let's give the Lord a hand of praise, everybody. Oh God, our Father, here we are again, another sacred day, a day that you've made. You've made this day before the foundations of the world. And Father, we are in this day, not because we've been so good, not because we've been so kind, but because of your grace and your mercy. And for that, God, we celebrate you and we thank you for what you have done. We give you glory for what you have done, and we give you honor today. And now, God, as we dive into the Word of God, somebody came looking for an answer. Somebody came looking for peace. Somebody came looking for salvation. God, you do your work. And Lord, use me to hide myself behind the cross, that I may never glory in myself, but I may glory in you. This is our prayer today in Jesus' name. Amen. Today we continue in our series, Better Me. Beginning of the year, we've been in this series, and for every week we just decide no New Year's resolutions. We just want to be a better person. Amen. Anybody with me today? We're used to, if you've lived past 20 years of your life, you're used to making these New Year's resolutions, and then 3 weeks after you're in the new year, you're back to doing what you did, and sometimes worse. But this year, I purposed, as the Lord is speaking and dealing with us, we asking us to do several things, and I don't want to go through all of them because now the list is real long. Amen. You just got to stay with us, and you can always get our CDs or DVDs. But go with us today to the book of Romans, the book of Romans, chapter 8. For those of you who missed Bible study on Thursday night, you missed a treat. I was telling the chairman, if I've been pastoring you now, I'm in my 19th year of pastoring you, and if I ever have had a Bible study that I enjoyed the most, I now must say it was last Thursday night. Amen. It was an outstanding Bible study. And those of you who want to grow in the Word, don't just come to Sunday morning service. You grow through that Bible study and through the various classes that we offer here at East Zion Fair. Let's go to the Word of God in Romans chapter 8, very short verse, verse 1. Listen to what it says. Therefore, there is now no condemnation for those who are in Christ Jesus. Can I read it to you one more time? Therefore, there is now, somebody say now, no condemnation for those who are in Christ Jesus. Today, I just want to encourage your heart, and I want to talk about move beyond your mistakes. Come on, look at your neighbor real quickly, because they need to hear from you, and say, neighbor, I need for you to move beyond your mistakes. Now touch yourself and say, move beyond your mistakes. Come on, let's give the Lord a hand of praise. Humanity is plagued with being prisoners of their past, because Satan's objective is to keep before us all of the negative mistakes and missteps that are behind us, with the ultimate goal of returning us back to where we've been pardoned from. Oh, I thought that was real good. Satan wants you to keep remembering what you did wrong yesterday, so he can hold you hostage in what God wants to do with you today. Oh, I can hear you today. But here's your word this morning. There is now no condemnation for them who are in Christ Jesus. Our past have been pardoned by the finished works of Jesus Christ. Do I have a witness? The purpose of Calvary's experience was to lift us, not to imprison us. Jesus's work at Calvary remove the rags of scorn and replace them with the garments of salvation, regeneration, and sanctification, which gives us, check this out, it gives us a new name, a new identity, and a new destiny. What does that mean? That means who I used to be, I ain't him no more. So for every person who liked to bring up what you did yesterday, don't get mad. Don't get on Facebook and start trying to respond. This is what you ought to do. Just post, look at grace. So my brothers and sisters, it's time for us to make sure that we are living where God wants us to be, not in a place of torment, but in a place of praise. Because God wants you to help him defeat the enemy over your life. You have to show the enemy, yes, I've made mistakes in my life. Yes, I've done wrong, but I'm covered now. And what I've done then ain't gonna hold me hostage right now. Do I have a witness? There's a story, Brother Sherman, in John's gospel about a woman who was caught in the very act of adultery. A mob of meaningless men were ready to stone this woman to death. But Jesus stepped in, now watch this, not to defend her adultery, but to defend the adulteress. By saying, let the one who had never sinned to cast the first stone. Everybody who want to remind you of what you did wrong, ask them, what did they do wrong? Because there's not a person living, from the pastor back to the door, who have not done wrong in their past. Okay, I know. You are used to people making gods out of other people. Yes, the pastor is perfect and he has never made a mistake. The devil is a liar. I am the best illustration of what grace really is. Do I have anybody in here today who can be honest with yourself and say, had the Lord not looked beyond your faults, oh, I ain't got nobody to preach to today. Had the Lord not looked beyond your faults, you would not be in church today. But because of grace and mercy, you are a witness. Yeah, he told them, go ahead and cast your first stone if you think you've never sinned. But while he was telling them, he was writing on the ground, because he knew he had some self-righteous people in front of him, but he wanted them to know I'm God. So he started writing, this is my own interpretation, their sins on the ground. And as they saw their sins, they dropped their rocks. Brothers and sisters, it's easy to put your finger on somebody else when they have been exposed. But let me tell you about the God that I serve. You can't expose somebody else, because God can expose you. I don't know about you. I really don't know about you today, but whenever I hear of someone's failure, I try not to respond with some kind of holier-than-thou attitude. The first thing that comes to my mind is what John Bradford once said, but for the grace of God, there go I. We've got to learn to love people when they least expect it and when they least deserve it. Do I have a witness in here? This woman walked off the scenes of scripture, but before Jesus completed his charges, and before Jesus completed dealing with her, he changed the trajectory of her life, because grace is always the catalyst that turns guilt into a release. An act of grace turns devastating moments moments into defining moments of liberation. This was the moment that was given to this woman who was forgiven. It turned her mistakes into her release. She was free to go and be who God has called her to be. She was left with the opportunity to say, I'm going to stick with being labeled as an adulteress, or I'm going to take the words of Jesus who said, I have no fault with you as well. Brothers and sisters, who are you listening to? That's the question I need to ask you today. Who are you listening to? Are you listening to people, or are you listening to God? Because people will keep you in a prison, but God will set you free. Do I have a witness in here today? In the Old Testament, God delivered Israel out of Egypt in one day. Somebody say one day. But it took God 40 years to get Egypt out of Israel. Stay with me. For 40 years, the Israelites thought like slaves. They felt like slaves. They behaved like slaves. All because there was a psychological formation and an emotional stronghold on their mentality. Until they reached a place called Gilgal. Do I have a witness in here? That's the place of release. It was at Gilgal where God said to Israel, today, somebody say today. He said, today I have rolled away the shame of your past. Let me help somebody. Every path to promise must go through a place of release. You can't get to where God is trying to take you until you're first released where you are. Oh, I ain't gonna get no help in here. Sometimes it takes for the old nature to become your second nature a long time. Sometimes it takes time to break old habits and build new habits. But Jesus came to put our mistakes in a place where he and said he will never remember them again, which is behind us. Brothers and sisters, if I can't preach nothing else to you today, my word to you is to let your bad mistakes be in your past. God, if he was so angry with you, you would not be living right now. If God was so angry with you, you'll be dead, sleeping in a grave. But because you are here today, you can tell every demon in hell, God forgave, God moved me on, God allowed me to get up. And because I'm getting up, I'm going to be the threat to the kingdom of darkness. I'm going to spread the word about Jesus's grace, about Jesus's mercy, about Jesus's kindness, about Jesus's tender mercy. Listen to me carefully. You don't have to sit down and knuckle under to the devil. You can let the devil know where to go and what bus to catch, because Jesus has set you free. I ain't got nobody that's going to hang with me today. I feel this in my spirit today. Jesus has set you free. There are so many church people who can't grow in Jesus because they're still worried about what they did in their past. They feel everything negative that happens to them. God is getting them back. The devil is alive. My God is not malicious. My God is not one who seeks to hurt and to harm. He said, I've come that you might have life and that you might have it. Here's the question today. How do we, because I'm going to preach short today, Brother Chairman. How do we move beyond our mistakes? How do we move beyond our mistakes? I saw you, Brother Jones. You looked at, when Troy said, take your time, I saw you close your eyes. I'm paying attention. Don't you think I got my, I can see. How do we move beyond our mistakes? First, by recognizing. Somebody say, recognize. Matter of fact, look at your neighbor and say, you better recognize. The text says, watch this. Therefore, there is now. Somebody say now. Full forgiveness is in your present tense. I knew you would catch it. Oh, I gotta be careful here. Full forgiveness is right now. It's right here, right now, this day, and at this moment. You are forgiven. Stop feeling sorry for what you did yesterday. You are forgiven right now. This is no theory that Paul is speaking of in the text. Paul was an example of many horrendous and hideous sins and mistakes. What Paul did and witnessed could have crippled his spirit for the rest of his life. But it was his encounter with Jesus. Anybody had an encounter with Jesus? It was his encounter with Jesus that changed his thinking. It was the grace of God that enabled him to rid his regrets that could have stifled him for the rest of his life. And since his thinking was changed, he was able to move past his mistakes. It was the Apostle Paul who told the people in the church to be ye therefore transformed by the renewing of your mind. If you still got the old mind, you're gonna still think the old way. That's why Israel could not go into their promise when it was promised, because they still thought like slaves. What you did is behind you. You have to learn how to move forward. With a transformed mind, Paul used his mistakes and regrets to motivate his work for the Lord. I'm gonna help somebody. Never depreciate the grace of God by underestimating the level of your past brokenness. Paul called himself the chief of sinners. He freely admitted what he did wrong. That's why he was able to extend grace to others who he came in contact with. When you find people who can never find grace in their spirit for somebody else, it's because they have never experienced the grace of God. I don't understand these preachers who preach all of this hell and brimstone, but yet they fail to tell you that at the cross is where you can find the Savior. And at the cross is where you can find redemption. At the cross is where you can find a lifting of the things that you were stuck in. That's why Paul wrote throughout his books about the goodness and the grace of God, because he wanted people to know that you could be the chief of sinners back then. But when Jesus touches your life, you no longer who you used to be. Oh, I wish I had a real church in here real quickly. Because as I'm thinking about it, all of us have been in situations and places in our lives that if we were still back then, some of the people who talk about you wouldn't be talking about you. Hold up. Back it up, Curry. Let me tell you why. Because if they would have talked about you the way they're talking about you now, that grace is covering you, you would have went up in their grill a long time ago. But because of the grace of God, because of the mercy of God, because of the peace of God, had Paul nursed and rehearsed his mistakes, he would have been excluded from preaching the gospel of Jesus Christ. Had he nursed and rehearsed his mistakes, he would have never built all the churches that he built. Had he nursed and rehearsed his mistakes, he would have never wrote one third of the New Testament. But he knew that his past was pardoned. My brothers and sisters, before you step into new possibilities, you've got to move past your mistakes. If you allow your mistakes to hold you back, God can't use you. Oh, I wish I had help here. Because everybody has and is making mistakes. But the key is not to allow your mistakes to own you. See, if you let your mistakes own you, then you'll never be able to move on. But because the grace of God has forgiven you, you can lift your head up and say, yes, I'm sorry for what I did wrong. Yes, I'm sorry for the mistakes that I made. But listen, let me tell you, it's day
David said in the book of Psalms, he said, against thee and thee alone have I sinned, because all of our transgressions, all of our mess ups, all of our mistakes wasn't against people, it was against our God. And when you get that thing right with God, it doesn't matter about other people, because people will try to hold you hostage for the rest of your life. But you gotta break out of their prisons. You gotta break out of where they're trying to hold you. And you gotta say to them that God has made the provision. God has given me the opportunity, and I'm now free. Do I have a witness in here? My brothers and sisters, hear me very carefully. Judas made mistakes, and he made an ultimate mistake, and it caused him to commit suicide. Lot's wife made a mistake, and it caused her to become a pillar of salt. Achan's made a mistake, and it caused him to drop dead in front of the prophet. Peter made mistake, and it caused him to walk away from the body of Jesus Christ. Not because they were such horrible and deplorable people, but because they couldn't move on past their mistake. Listen to what I just said. Some people died in their mistake, but the Lord is saying, if you can hear this word today, you need to recognize that grace is available. You need to recognize that I am the one who's able to forgive you and move you to the next level of God's glory. Do I have a witness in here? But not only do we move beyond our mistake by recognizing, but also by releasing. Somebody say release. Come on, I can't hear you. Somebody say release. The text says there is now no condemnation for those who are in Christ us, Jesus Christ, and what he did at Calvary's cross changed everything for humanity. It was at Calvary that changed our mistakes into possibilities. It was at Calvary where Jesus broke the chain of guilt, remorse, and of shame. Calvary was history's greatest accomplishment for humanity's mistakes. But sometimes we shortchange the finished works of Calvary because we fail to release the mistakes of our past. But releasing yesterday allows us to pursue our freedom today. Releasing yesterday allows us to pursue forgiveness right now. Releasing yesterday allows us to pursue victory right now, which means regardless of what happened yesterday, we can rise, we can shine, we can give God the glory right now. Hold it, Pastor. How can I give God glory with all the mistakes that I made in my life? Because Jesus came to pay the price of all of our sins. And you can rise, you can shine, and you can give God the glory. Do I have a witness in here today? And I want to just give a little quick reminder to some person in here who's listening to me right now. The reason why the enemy keep bringing up your past, the reason why the enemy don't want you to move on, the reason why I'm agitating your spirit right now, is because the enemy knows that in your weakest moment, you're still the greatest threat to the kingdom of darkness. The enemy knows if you could ever release yourself and feel that God has forgiven you, you will be able to bring souls to Christ. You will be able to share of his goodness. Do I have anybody here who've ever been released of their sins and you went to telling people about the goodness of God? You went to telling people about how grace made it possible for you to be able to stand. People in the old community, they will talk about who you used to be, but thanks be to God who has given you victory, and now you're not the person who you used to be, but you're the person. Listen, you gotta release. You have to release. What you can't redeem, you gotta release. What you can't repair, you gotta release. What you can't revive, you gotta release. What you can't resuscitate, you gotta release. What you can't recover, you've got to release. Because God has already handled all of your mistakes and miscalculations. Do I have a witness? Last night when I was putting the message together, I threw this in here. When we confess, God dismiss. When we, watch this, own up, God shows up. When we admit, God omit. When we disclose, God foreclose. So now, release what you're holding. God has dismissed it out of your life. God has made your life better. You've lived beyond it. If you're gonna be a better person, you're gonna have to release the stuff that's holding you down. You are eligible for the kingdom of God. You are eligible for the blessings of God. You are eligible to rise and shine and give God glory. Here's my last point. Not only do we move beyond our mistakes by recognizing and releasing, and here's it, but also by remembering. Somebody say remembering. The most important prayer in all of Judaism is found in the book of Deuteronomy chapter 6. It's called the Shema. The Jewish people draped their door frames with this prayer as a daily reminder of God's sovereignty. Do you know what sovereignty means? He could do what he want to do, when he want to do it, how he want to do it, and who, with whomever he want to do it with. They put this over the doorstep to remind them of God's grace and of God's goodness. In other words, it was a sacred reminder of what God had done for them. Can I suggest, instead of surrounding yourself with the negative Facebook, instead of surrounding yourself with the negative Instagram and TikTok, TikTok, whoever it is, can I implore you to surround yourself with some sacred reminders? Pastor, what are some sacred reminders? Lo, I am with you always. When you're up and when you're down, even until the end of the world. Give me another one, Pastor. If God be for me, it doesn't matter what's against me. Give me another one, Pastor. No weapon formed against me shall prosper. But the text didn't end there. And every tongue that rises up shall be condemned. Can I give you another one? Everything is working for my good. You see, the more you remind yourself of the sacred realities in your Christian walk, the better you have a chance of surviving. You can remind yourself that the Lord is my shepherd and I shall not want. Surround yourself with reminders so you won't get stuck in your mistakes of the past. Satan knows our weaknesses and he's working to exploit them. He wants you out of the game. Can I say it to you again? He wants you out of the game. He doesn't want you on the Lord's side. He always wants you in a position of feeling sorry for yourself. He wants you in a position where you always feeling pitiful. Lift up your head. Stop being a chicken and recognize that the grace of God is on your life. Do I have a witness? In our text, it says, therefore, now, not next week, not next year, but now, there is no condemnation over and over and over again. Satan will replay your regrets and your mistakes in your mind, because the devil knows, if I'm gonna take her out, if I'm gonna take him out, I gotta do it in their mind, so that your emotional and your mental energy will be filled with the negativity of yesterday. But today, God is saying, I want you to move beyond your mistakes, move beyond your misfortunes, and rise and let God have his way. You've been cleared at Calvary. Jesus, he forgave you at Calvary. You are now set and ready for your future. Rise. Let the enemy know, I did make mistakes, but God is my refuge and my strength, a very present help in the time of trouble. My brothers and sisters, you got to get to moving. Come on and tag your neighbor and say, neighbor, get to moving, get to moving. Don't sit any longer. Get to moving. Get the fire back in your life. God is blessing you. God is healing you. God is raising you. God is giving you another chance. Rise and move. Move and watch God bless your life. Everybody standing.
You have been watching our previously recorded broadcast from Wilmington's most exciting church.